Hello there. In this video, I will discuss on network protocol abuses. How they do it? Mainly abnormal network traffic patterns, problem that they can create or mask, and bug from nature of complex system like TCP and IP. Type of attacks. There is two main interest of an IDS intrusion attacks basically. One is network level attack, another is presentation layer and ABAP, that means up to application layer, some attacks happens. So in network level attacks, session layer and below, that means up to physical layers, are basically attempt to subvert, disrupt and gather information on the transport of data from source to destination. But on the other hand, in presentation layer and above up to application layer, the attackers are going to target the host. They subvert, disturb, or gather information on the targeted systems. Now, network protocol abuses, ARP protocol abuses, IP protocol abuses. Okay, there is many other like UDP abuses and TCP abuses. I'm not just reading the sub points. I'm go through other things. There are some more abuses on protocols. Now, first one is ARP abuses. So, in ARP abuses, mainly what happens? ARP flooding. We all know what is what is the use of ARP protocol. It is used to do address resolution, basically IP address resolution, right? So what can happen, the attacker can use this protocol to create some broadcast or some sending some message where destination is not reachable, okay? And and in case of by doing this, if somehow the attacker gets succeed to flood the buffer in the switch of where the ARP entries are stored, then that switch for the some time can start acting like a hub. That means that configurations are going to be deactivated for some time, so that switch can simply go for a restart. If it goes for a restart, then also after restarting, the buffer will be empty, and creating the new buffer or entries and the switch will take some time. And this is the point, a loophole the attackers use to do the attacks. So there are some guidelines to carve this down is configure the ARP entry limit, configure ARP packet rate limit, and configure strict ARP learning. Then max spoofing, it is again kind of man-in-middle attack. Say in this network you can see three user or host are there, host A, host B, and host C. And here host C is actually the attacker. And here you can see in step one, user A is trying to communicate with user B. So what user A does, it try to send some message to B, but in the meantime, attacker C snoofs the data and starts acting like he is A. So C start communicating with C, thinking that B is communicating with C, thinking that B is communicating with A, but actually B is started communicating with C. Then ARP spoofing. In this case, what happens? It is ARP is address resolution protocol. So here, host A want to communicate with host C. So host A have the IP address of host B. So what host A does, it circulate a packet, broadcast a packet in the network that who is having this IP address, please send your MAC address so that I can start communicating with you. But host C somehow copied the MAC address of host B, and it replies that I have this MAC address, and this reply goes to A, and A thinks that that reply came from the authentic user and start communicating with C. So C starts acting like a B, right? So this is what happens due to ARP spoofing. Then IP address spoofing is another way of doing it. Then UDP flag attack, that means you know, this is very interesting. The attacker sends a message to victim A and changes the header by change the header sender's IP address and puts the IP address of sender's IP address as B's IP address. Okay, so the reply that victim A gives goes to victim B, and victim A again replies to A. So this attacker is very intelligent. He just starts the communication between A and B and then stops itself, and A and B gets busy into the communication and makes the network busy, due to which the resources can be misutilized, and some DOS attack can be initiated. There is Marf attack. You can say kind of amplification of the previous one. It sends the attacker sends a request to the router, and router replies and it sends by the broadcast address. Okay, the source address it puts, the attacker puts, is the broadcast address. So the router reply to the broadcast address of the network, and the reply goes to each of the devices in the network, and all these devices start replying to the victim, which is the device having the broadcast address. Okay, so in this way, Marf attack can be happen, which is also called as traffic amplification. Then problem with fragments, that means when packets are going to be transferred over the net, if some packet is big enough or more than the handleable size of some device, then the packet is going to be splitted into multiple parts and then retransmitted. Okay, so that here the problems comes with some attacker can just duplicate the fragment and resend it, can make overlap fragments and resend in the network. Okay, ping of death and odd size packets. Usually the packets are uniform sized. Okay, then firewall evasion. These are the different attack mode the attacker can follow based on packet fragments. And here is the IDS evolution by manipulation of TTL, that is the total time to live. Okay, so what does happens here, the attacker try to find out where is the intrusion detection system of the target network. Then it sends a normal packet which is not malicious with the TTL greater than 1 to the IDS. So TTL is the number how many nodes the packet can travel. So say here that this is the pip node from the attacker. Okay, the IDS is the pip node. Then the attacker will send a packet with TTL 5. So that normal packet, which is not malicious, and it will trace to the IDS, and IDS will just record the attacker's IP address as a safe IP address. Then it will send another packet with TTL 6. Okay, which will just destroy after crossing the IDS, intrusion detection system, but not do any malfunction or anything malicious. And finally, say the target machine is at the 7th node, so from the attacker. So attacker will set the TTL finally to 7 and send a malicious packet now, and that malicious packet come to the destination victim, and it will do whatever the attacker wants to do here, so that IDS will not be able to detect the packets from this attacker as a malicious packet. Then IP option, there are different options in IP header which are used to do attacks. These options are going to be changed by some attacker and do some attack. Then TCP abuses. In TCP, one of the big scope is mismanaging the flags or misconfiguring the flags. Now, some knowledge you may have that some combination of flags cannot be activated together, initialize a connection and finish a connection can't be happen together. Okay, so like this, initialize connection and reset connection, acknowledgement and finalize and initialize connection, all these things together can't happen. So these are the things. Then initialize connection floods, that means the attacker is sending too many connection initialization. TCP sends it, TCP protocol. So many TCP connection initialization request to a server, so that some legitimate client is not getting a chance to send its packet to the server to get a connection. Then backscatter is another one. The attacker sends a TCP request to the victim, from a path, okay, and changing the source addresses, and the victim start sending the acknowledgement to different host, which from which host the victim actually did not get the initialized connection request. And for that thing, usually the attackers uses a different path to send the request. Then ICMP abuses used by the attackers to do different kind of DOS attacks. So it there are some tools using which it can be done, like Locky ICMP backdoor attacker tool, and then Snaky tool. These are the different tools. Thank you for watching.